shot to get open, then putting it on net. Whoa. This comes way, way after. Keep in mind, whoa. Murray just misses the first one. Remember, it was Murray that went after Kopitar. Actually, they ran into each other. And both guys take their helmet off, Bob. So, again, Murray wears a face shield, but he took it off.
Clifford and Murray.
So they'll probably, again, there would not be an instigator here against Murray anyway, because both guys, it was so obvious what was going to go on. Murray is just so strong, 245, so he has the weight advantage. Clifford's just trying to use the guile as a fighter. When you see, that's the second time Murray's missed with a big right hand. Now he's going off the top of the head, and Clifford comes back himself. Both guys go down. Wow. I always give Kyle Clifford credit. But right there, he knows. He knows he's going into a scrap against the guy that outweighs him by almost 30 pounds. And then Murray, you know, takes off the helmet, so there's no visor involved. So obviously both guys probably had a little bit of a chat before they got onto the ice. And it's right here. This is where it's going to happen right here. You see Clifford moving into a situation. Pavelski saying, no, you're not going. Then they say, yes, you do. See up the top. And then Clifford does the same thing because Murray takes off his helmet. Clifford takes off his. Now, Bob, that would be a four-hour discussion to go into people who don't like fighting anyway. And then they see two guys taking their helmets off to get involved. But that's just keeping it fair. Two guys without a helmet going at it. 5 minutes each for fighting.
Canucks were so good at that the other night. Tonight, they have not done the job.
Here we go. It's Ginla and Willie Mitchell. There had been rumblings of this possibility before the game. And now the captain goes at Mitchell, one of the leaders of the Canucks. Mitchell trying to get his left arm free, and now he's throwing some jackhammers. Ginla covering up his sweater over his head. Now he's back up.
Game two, Mark. Do these guys care?
And Ginla fails Mitchell with a solid shot. And now the linesman busted out.
Well, Scott Oak was absolutely right. This has more of a feel of a game at the end of the season vying for a playoff spot. Jerome Ginla trying to fire up the fans, and Willie Mitchell trying to stand up for his Canucks team.
Well, Ginla's equipment coming apart in that scrap. Let's take a look at how it all began.
These guys would have talked right off the face-off, and there's the Warriors. They take off the helmet. Nobody wants to break a hand on a helmet, not guys that have been in the league this long.
And then Ginla got one good shot, that left hook right there, and that buckled Mitchell, who'd had a couple of three good shots before that.
95. Lightning get it from the draw, Hedman with it, shooting. And now we've got Konopka dropping the gloves.
It's Steckel, isn't it?
And he's going to go with Dave Steckel. And Konopka scoring with a left jab to begin with. And Steckel, big at 6'5 and 217. Konopka comes back with a big right. And he's fired away with more rights. And he connects with another right. Couple of uppercuts. And Steckel is in trouble. He's getting pounded by an elbow pad repeatedly here. And the linesman come in there to separate him. And that should finish it off. A postscript for the Lightning ending a long losing streak of 12 games to the Washington Capitals right there.
Well, I'll tell you what, you could see that was going to happen. I think they were having words right at that face-off before things really got dropped. 16-17 will be the time of the majors. There you see, there's the one he came across with the one right hand. And right in here is when I think that one there, I think, kind of stunned him and hurt him a little bit. He was trying to grab on Steckel and pull him down, but Steckel's, or pardon me, Konopka's really strong in his skates.
Series through the first two games in a period. Here's a fight, Parros and Murray. This goes back to the hit on Solani.
Well, Parros at 6'5", 231 has the reach, certainly. And Parros trying to drop some bombs, and Murray hanging tough. And they're not done yet. Barrow's trying to lose that elbow pad.
Some cerebral pugilists there.
Barrow's the product of Princeton University. And Murray out of Cornell.
It's an Ivy League dust up.
Hey guys, that Douglas Murray George Perros rivalry goes back a long way. Actually, before college, they played against each other in high school, and they definitely like to get the better of one another. Found out today they actually keep track of how often they knock each other down. Wasn't able to get my hands on their career numbers against one another, but Murray was careful to point out that Perros had not knocked him down yet this year. The last time he did was last year in the preseason. He said, "I'm not going to forget that."
Tonight's contest between the Avalanche and the Islanders. The Avalanche have not won in this building since 1998.
Here we go, Michael.
And we got a fight right at the start. The puck is dropped and Stewart is set to go. And they were talking to each other before the start of the game. Konopka for the New York Islanders. Denon Konopka and Chris Stewart dropping the glove 5 seconds after the start of the game. Konopka with a right hand and Stewart backing up. He delivers a right himself. And then a left by Stewart. Konopka comes over with a roundhouse right. Then they keep whirling around. And then an elbow pad goes flying. This fight continuing on between Stewart and Konopka. Denon Konopka, Chris Stewart. Now Stewart really starting to pound and land some punches right for the New York bench. And the linesman, the referee's letting this go a long time. Konopka and Stewart, who during the pregame warm-up were drawn at each other, and it took just 5 seconds for the glove to get dropped. And this long fight, both seem to be getting a little arm-weary at this point. And the linesmen are creeping their way in, and Stewart and Konopka both landed some punches. Stewart had a nice flurry during that fight as well.
9-6 Tampa Bay. And Tavares showing a seat by Matias Olin. Now Malone.
And now a clean hit. Matt Martin's trying to get. Oh, Nate Thompson's going to go with Matt Martin. He's responded to the challenge.
All that happened while Malone was driving to the net, getting into position for a scoring chance. And
first fight for Nate Thompson as a Lightning player after fighting 5 times for the Islanders this season.
If anybody throws a punch. All right, that starts it finally. Martin with an overhand right that didn't seem to do much. That one did more, and so did the third. And now Martin with a couple of big hits against Nate Thompson, who's trying at first to hold on, and then he returns fire. So they got to give Nate credit for hanging in after Martin had really gotten the better of him. And the linesmen want them to punch each other until they're tired.
And a big right there from Nate. Boy, Matt Martin strong on his skates, too.
Linesman just wanted to let him get it out of their system. And Martin had a big right hand.
This is a great scrap. It's an honest, fair scrap here.
Another reason the linesman let him go. They might have enjoyed it, too.
There's a lot of hair on those helmets, too, aren't there?
The rather hirsute messes Martin and Thompson head on.
Watch number 5, Matias Olin, stand up after Thompson flushes Tavares to the side, and he gets hit cleanly. Now, Matt Martin knows what he has to do right here. I'm not always a proponent of guys who get clean hit looking for a fight, but this one is when your young star gets hit, that's the exception. To their credit, both players take their helmets off. They have an excellent scrap, and watch this, guys. Nate Thompson telling Matt Martin.
Clean play there. He was looking for Crosby up ice. And now,
oh, Bissonnette and Bradley.
Yep, we thought this might happen here tonight. It wouldn't be a heavyweight battle, but maybe a middleweight battle. Bissonnette.
Oh, hit him, hit him,
oh,
hit
my
him.
Goodness.
He collapsed him. And then now Bissonnette goes down. Oh, Bradley's down again. He's in trouble. Yeah, he hit him with the first one. Bissonnette hit Bradley with the first one, and there's Bradley's got some issues right now, and there's blood all over the ice.
And he opened him up above his left eye, it appeared.
Well, he hit him with the first punch of the fight. I can't believe Matt Bradley. Boy, is he tough to stand up to that first punch. He somehow was able to regain himself just for a bit. Oh, boy. What a fight. And right there, Bissonnette got back up and hit him again. And really, it was the effects, the residual of the first punch, and then just another Shot to the chin. And down went Bradley. And he's going to have to get attended to, not just the cut,